Today we transition from the morning to the afternoon, which is not a good sign for your patients. It's been a long morning. I should start by sharing the pleasure to be with you in Hong Kong, welcome you in Hong Kong, because I chair Schneider, and I'm the CEO of Schneider, but I've been living in Hong Kong for the past 7 years in Asia. And why is that? In the past 20 years, we saw that Asia would be leading the growth of our business, of our industry. I had the privilege personally to be in the team that created Schneider in China, where today we have 25,000 people. And we started India 15 years ago, and we have today 20,000 people in India, 12,000 people in Southeast Asia, 5,000 in the Pacific, 5,000 in Japan. And we did that at the beginning in a rather classical way, which is you send people, and you develop people, and you recruit people. And then 7 years ago, with part of my team, we said, well, we have to go to trenches in the front line and accelerate that. And this is why we've been living here on developing Asia from Asia and leading the group globally, actually, from here. It's been very beneficial to us because Asia, of course, has become the biggest region of the company. Some of you in this room might ask themselves, what is Schneider Electric doing in an IT conference? And actually, you know us on a different passport. And I did that in 2007. I married APC together with Schneider Electric to solve the global equation of reliability and efficiency in the field of IT, powering the data center and bringing energy to the data center. And by the way, we did the merger on Valentine's Day, which is always good for a merger. You have to be very precise in everything you do, okay? But it's great to say that 20 years or almost after, that has proven a great combination, and you've helped us and supported us in this journey. And I want to thank you as I start with this conference. But why is Schneider Electric in an IT conference? First, because over the past 15 years, we've connected everything in the systems we sell. We've developed IP-connected architectures in every of the business we serve, from connected products into edge control, which are precisely adapted to every application, and then to a set of software, digital services, analytics, AI that we plug to give sense to the data. And today, everything which is connected represents already 50% of the business of Schneider, $15 billion. Then, in parallel, IT as an end market is now 15% of our business. It's grown consistently 10% every year, including in the years of crisis. We are number one in what we do in this segment. And it has become our largest market in the world, ahead of what used to be the traditional utility business, oil and gas business, food and beverage business. IT has become the biggest segment. And why is that? Again, if we keep drilling, because we are living in a very exciting time. And we live at the convergence of digital and power. What we see today is that digital drives power. If you look at the equation of energy, and you look forward 15 years, energy consumption will increase one-fold, electricity will grow at twice the pace, and IT will grow four times. That's pretty much it. One, two, four, right? 60% of what we see here is driven by IP traffic on associated networks, but the rest of the IT consumption of electricity is about chip manufacturing. And if you put together chip manufacturing on traffic, you've got the fastest electricity consumption in the world. Now, if you want to make your electricity efficient, making it digital is the only way or the best way. We systematically in every application can reach 20 to 30% efficiency by mixing or converting digital and power together. Now, of course, digital, everything which is digital is very sensitive to the quality of power. We need, as we develop more digitization in all of our industries, develop completely integrated solutions for power. So what we see today is that 90% of the companies in the past have experienced loss of their critical systems. 35% of them are coming from a problem of power. On 1 hour of loss, for instance, on the trading floor, has huge consequences. 6 million euros on the trading floor. But you could go into every industry, the loss incurred by 1 hour of loss of a critical mission, part of the process, very often powered by power, has tremendous consequences. We see at the moment, in our sector, in our industry, we see three major transitions. The first one that was well commented by Renshin and all of us is the fact that everything is getting connected and everything that is getting powered or given intelligence by AI, right? Or sense, the connectivity is given sense by the power of computing developed by AI. And rather than talking about the theory of that, I'd like to take a few examples of that, on some example in Asia. So let's start by Thailand, SuperNAP, which is a data center. It's an interesting example, completely connected, integrated infrastructure architecture. And that is an interesting example. That's a subsidiary of Switch in the US. So Schneider being strong in the US, having Switch as a customer, we translated the architecture of the US into the needs of Thailand. The fact that everything is powered by one integrated software architecture allows the customer to gain competitive edge by guaranteeing a 100% uptime to its customers on 30% on productivity. Another example that we need to is Bigger Data, who is one of our great partners in the Pacific, is to work on Christie Space, you could say the WeWork in Australia. Only, of course, it's a completely different environment. It's about edge data centers that the customer is putting at the disposal of its customers in those offices, so that they can increase the yield on the rental by 12%. They can also reduce their operating costs of the data center by 16% by integrating all of that in one architecture. Going to the next case, and we go on the west coast, on the west of the US, I'll speak about a utility IT system that they have to retrofit completely. This case is quite interesting because it's a mix of centralized data center on edge data centers that needed to be integrated into one system. So by integrating all of this within EcoStruxure IT, they got a reduction of their space for racks, 75% of combined improvement in power usage effectiveness, and 100% of the critical applications were successfully migrated with no bleed. One interesting thing is that this is addressing 500 remote sites, which we, of course, did with our partners. On the fact that we could partner the deployment of that with our local distributors, integrators, made that deployment possible in a record time. Final one I want to comment is ADNOC. You are in Abu Dhabi, and this is one of the biggest oil and gas deployment. And what ADNOC wanted was one complete repository of their industrial installations on one big control room with screens putting together all the elements to manage. You see the quantities to be produced and be shipped. And this is what we operated. I'm going to be with them actually at the end of the year to draw the lessons of this implementation. But we have on one repository the whole of ADNOC there. And all of this is IT going into the sector of OT or into the field of OT. Second transition, we see that when we speak about digitization, very often people think about the IoT on real-time connectivity on the combination of one, a lot of objects connected, second, aggregation of data through big data, and then deployment of computing through AI. But the big efficiency that we see is that the whole process from design to maintenance is getting digitized for much more efficiency. So more efficiency at the time of the design, Because in the old world of construction, 60% of the budgets today in average are new works of the installation, plus managing the complexity of work sites, of people colliding against each other. Then you've got a massive loss of efficiency when you transition the digital model from design into the operation phase. And then there is very little learning from the operation back into the design. So what we are working in parallel of digitization of real design is that integration of the life cycle of installations, which brings also the double value of making sure that every modification is registered on the digital twin, and every learning from the operation is fed back at the initial of the design so that the next design can become better. The third transition, of course, is the interesting one between centralization and decentralization. We've seen the IT, which is an expert of that, of going back and forth, driving the movement to the cloud in the past 10 years. What we've seen in the recent movement is back to the edge, because the more you bring things to the cloud, the more things we can bring to the edge. Not a bad opportunity for our common profession, I would say, so we have to accompany those movements. Things that people have less seen is that the same thing is happening at the level of energy. The cloud of energy is a grid. And what we've seen in the past 5 years, and it's a recent movement, is an explosion of microgrid, of decentralized generation, which is only possible if you digitize, because you've got to really coordinate very closely what's happening on the grid, what's happening on the edge, to make sure that this is reliable. So you've seen those two movements of digital of power going together, which is a great opportunity for all of us, because every time we deploy digital on the edge, we have to make sure the right solution for power is deployed. And every time we push back things on the cloud, we have to make sure that there is enough supply to supply the big computing which is happening on the cloud. So what's the role of Schneider there? Our role is very simple. In the 21st century, personally I live in many emerging countries, we know that still many people don't have access to a reliable energy. So our main mission is to supply energy, because energy is the base of life. So anybody who's lived in emerging countries knows that. If you don't have access to energy, your life is miserable. For anybody who is living with teenagers, we know also that if you don't have access to digital, your life is miserable. When your teenagers come to a new place, they don't ask you if there is power, they don't care about power, they ask if there is Wi-Fi. Okay? Because digital is your access for your teenagers to whatever is in your life, but for all of us, it's access to business, it's access to education, it's access to the world. What we do at Schneider is to develop combined or supply combined solutions of power and digital, because they are the source of life. So we make sure that life is on for everyone, everywhere, and at every moment. So a small picture of our company, $30 billion, big investment and permanent investment in R&D, a lot of it in software, connectivity. And probably one thing which is unlike other companies, our footprint is perfectly balanced between Asia-Pac, which is now number one, Western Europe, and North America, roughly the same size of business across that. And in terms of application, we do 50% of our business in commercial application, namely building on data centers, and 50% in what I call heavy-duty application, industry and cities. But IT, on what we do together, which was in the past going mostly in the IT space, 15% of our turnover, is going now everywhere with a convergence on OT and IT. And our job is to make sure that we go together, we bring you into those new spaces, because they represent as many barriers or opportunities of business.